Hello everyone, this is Chensey and welcome to my third devlog of the Princess of Seas, Generating Biome. In this video, I will divide the world into several small biomes for further process. If you are the first time watching my video, please consider subscribing. There will be more devlogs of my game every month. Last time, we created the basic shape of the land and sea. This time, we will add biome to the world. But before we start generating, there is one question I must answer. What is a biome? According to Wikipedia, a biome is a large collection of flora and fauna occupying a major habitat. Well, in another word, it means a kind of land that holds specific animals and plants. In a game, a biome usually means a certain kind of area that spawns unique resources and enemies. In Terraria, hailstone can only be found in the underworld biome. The mud is usually in the jungle biome. In order to collect different resources, one has to visit all the biomes in the world and that will waste the player a good amount of time. That will bring a lot of interest to the player. As a seasailing game, biome is not that important because the player spends most of their time on the sea. However, I still need biomechanics to add different decorations to the land. For example, some of the lands would be covered by grass while other parts of the world are filled with trees. That would make the game look much better, compared with a bare land. Our next question is, how could I generate a biome? Well, there are several possible solutions. Some games assign different biomes to a different level in the world. Say, the first level is on grassland. The level right after is a desert. But this does not work for open world game as there is only one level in the whole game. The second approach is to assign the biome with predetermined logic and some randomness. In the third zone of the game Crypt of the Necrodancer, there will be three biomes on the map. Normal, Ice, and Fire. I don't know how exactly the game generates the map, but I found an article explaining a random pick method that would reach a similar result. We would firstly choose a biome and set it on the map, then expand the area to occupy more space. Repeat it to every biome and we can get a good result. I personally believe this randomness with predetermined logic could be the most common way in game development, because it's easy to implement and the results looks good. The last way, which is the approach I use in Princess of Sea, is simulation. I need to understand how real-world biomes are formed and act accordingly. You can see, biomes in real-world are created with rules. It's based on the temperature and precipitation. Sounds simple to me. At least sounds simple to me at the beginning because I just need to generate the data of temperature and precipitation. The rule of temperature is relatively easy. The equator is the hottest area while the poles are the coldest. Do a linear interpolation and add some noise. Looking good. The precipitation, on the other hand, is not that easy. I need to consider atmospheric circulation, water cycle, ocean currents and many other factors. I think it's way too complex because I just want to make an interesting game. So, as a software developer, I try to make it simple. Generating a purring noise and use it as the basic precipitation data. Following the logic of atmospheric circulation, move the rains from some of the area to the others. Well, I know it could be a bit confusing why I need to reduce the rain in some part and add it to the others, but atmospheric circulation is so complex. I have checked the videos, websites, paper, and books, but I have to admit that geography theory is more than what a developer can understand. All I can say is, don't ask me why, just following the rule. Okay, we have all the data we need, and now is the time to generate the biome. The first step is to determine what kind of biome are there in the world. Google says there are 5 major biomes, or 8 common biomes, and 10 top biomes. Okay, we need to decide which biomes to include in the game. After a casual pick, I choose 8 biomes and assign the temperature and precipitation to them. With everything prepared, generating the biome is easy. For a given cell of the world, read the temperature data and precipitation value. Look in the biome table. Determine the kind of biome. Do that to every corner of the world and it looks much better now. Wow, cool. I can eventually assign the biome to my world. The next step should be generating plants. I think that's enough for today. Please press like and do subscribe if you like my game. I will post my thoughts and progress during the development. The link to the game is in the description. See you next time.